Norwell takes Fifer, as Derbyshire are bowled out for under 200 on day one. The cavernous Edgbaston played host to the opening fixture in Group 1 for these two sides. They're joined by Durham, Nottinghamshire, Worcestershire and 2020 champions Essex. There are just two places up for grabs at the end of the season, with the best two performers from across the tournament rewarded with a place in the final. And Warwickshire started in inspired form, staking their claim for silverware with an opening blast of wickets. Two in the second over of the season saw Godelman caught behind off the bowling of Norwell as he prodded forward, and then Anuj Dahl had his stumps rearranged, the off-peg remove from the ground. It didn't get much better. Lewis Deploy looked to leave a Hannon-Dalby delivery, but didn't remove the bat in time, and dragged on to become the third Derbyshire bat in a row to depart without scoring. Lewis Rees and Wayne Madsen dropped anchor in the face of some testing Warwickshire bowling, the sanctuary of lunch not far off. The partnership did well and ensured they'd reach the interval with 50 on the board, but Madsen would fall as soon as they'd reached the milestone, courtesy of a spectacular diving catch by Rob Yates. The damaging wicket meant that Derbyshire limped through to lunch at 58 for 4, with Matt Critchley and Lewis Rees at the crease. Derbyshire came out with renewed vigour, where once they were watchful, they found boundaries, and Warwickshire were made to suffer. An expensive miles over saw Critchley rack up 4 consecutive boundaries and take his side through to 3 figures. Their attacking intent was rewarded. Rees was the first of the two to reach a half century, brought up with a swept 4 off Briggs, and Critchley followed shortly. He punched Brosnan for 4 to pick up his 11th first-class 50. Warwickshire would find the wicket they'd been hunting for. Norwell found the edge of Rees's bat, and the ball nestled in Sam Haynes' waiting hands. Hossain could only add 2 before he fell to the same combination, Haynes once again with the catch in the cordon. Critchley was a landmark wicket for Norwell. Brosnan held on to the catch in the slips, and the 29-year-old had an 11th fifer as a reward for his good work so far. Will Rhodes struck late in the session to remove Finn Hudson-Prentice and leave Derbyshire 164 for 8 at tee. Michael Cohen was removed soon after the restart. Craig Miles found an edge through to Brosnan in the slips to leave the home side just one wicket away from getting their batting innings up and running. The final wicket partnership dug in though, and where previously Warwickshire were conjuring up the breakthroughs they needed, dismissals were hard to come by. Aitchison and Connors added some respectability to the side's score and frustrated the Bears' attack in the dying Birmingham light. Sam Connors would be the final wicket to fall for the visitors. Briggs got his name on the score sheet courtesy of a fine catch from Sam Hain at short leg. Derbyshire were all out for 189, a somewhat disappointing first innings total, but quite a recovery considering their difficulties at the top of the order. But the Bears wouldn't have it all their own way. Will Rhodes was quick to depart, trapped in front by Connors with just the second ball of the innings. England's Dom Sibley was joined by Rob Yates, and the pair ensured that Warwickshire finished the day without further loss, reaching the close of play at 13 for 1. It had been a good day for the Bears. They denied their visitors a potentially crucial batting bonus point, largely down to the excellent work of Liam Norwell. His fifer underlined Warwickshire's dominance with the ball, but if the start to their batting innings is any indication, this match could end up being much tighter than it currently seems.